Just do it. Like, I don't want to be cliche like Nike. Just do it. We started our show, we started with a phone. We started with one camera. I started with the audio on my iPhone. Just started. It looked like shit when we started. Right? Episode 1 to maybe about 40 was like very poor quality. Audio-wise, video-wise. But I just started it. And we make the mistakes in front of the people, and we improve in front of the people, so people can, the people who are day one fans really, really will know, because they'll be like, wow, these guys stepped their game up.
Yeah. Like, yeah, that Jodeci phase, those niggas were on top of the world. You have to remember that.
They were doing mad coke at the same time, too, so they were wilding the fuck out. You know what I'm saying?
Cocaine's one hell of a drug.
Hell yeah, shout out to Rick James.
Yeah, quote the man himself.
You know what I'm saying?
So, think about me sitting here reminiscing about Charlie Murphy kicking my ass. Huh?
The new fans will be like, wow, this is pretty cool quality stuff that you guys are putting out, right? Because right now we got great audio, we've got pretty good video, and we're doing our thing. But the day one fan, they'll be able to be like, I remember when they just had the one camera system and like you could hear the whole room in the audio. So my advice is just start it. Right? If it's something you like to do, you'll continue to improve it as you go along.
Wow, what kind of equipment have you been using for your podcast?
I use 4R20 microphones or RA20 microphones. We try to do like a two camera angle thing going on. So I have a Sony A6300 or two Sony A6300 cameras that we use sometimes. And then we have an additional camera that one of my videographers, Young Gucci Official, brings on the scene with him. I don't know exactly the name of his camera, but it's like a very high end 4K camera that he uses for music videos as well. So we use those, a combination of those three cameras, those microphones, and I have four of those mics, okay? Just to touch on those are the microphones, the standard microphones for broadcasting and podcasting, okay? When we started, we had one. Actually, we didn't have any, right? Eventually, when I started buying more microphones, I got myself the best mic, being the A mic. I bought myself the best mic, and everybody had like a pretty good mic. And then I had one R80, or RA80, or RA20, my bad. Now we have four. All right, so the guests use them, my co-host uses one, we all use them, all right? So I really make sure that the sound quality is really good, because the audio is also very important that goes out every Thursday morning. Also, it's mixed with the Zoom, the H6 Zoom is what we use. It's very handy piece of equipment that is portable. A lot of people use it for podcasting as well as like, I see KOTD, shout out to KOTD. I see them film taping their audio for their battles with it. They just add the extension piece with the ball mic on the end, and one guy just sits there and holds it through the whole battle and just records the audio separately on that. So, and my lights, I don't know which kind of lights they are, I don't know the name, but that's pretty much our setup now.
Some of the ways you've been trying to monetize We Love Hip Hop?
That's not always the easiest thing, but is also an easy thing. So I'll explain. For example, when you have an audience that's growing and who's engaged, then that's something that could be monetized, okay? However, we had the YouTube channel that was monetized before, the old YouTube channel, and it was accumulating money monthly. That one went down. I started a new YouTube channel immediately, right? Which is still waiting for monetization, maybe 6 months later. Right, we're going through the whole red tape and responses back from YouTube. So there's no monetization on our YouTube channel as of yet. So I had to start being more creative. Right, by gaining the notoriety, enables us to go and do live appearances. Right, so we've been able to do the live podcast for a few different people, including the Youngsterdam, Success. A few different companies have invited us to come through and then set up the podcast and do it live. We did it at some kind of a 420 festival or something like that, some Canna Cup, right? So, you know, that also pays. Because of the fact that we've been able to gain a high following via Instagram and all the different social media platforms that I control, you know, we get paid for postings, right? Artists who want to get their music videos, get some more push on their music videos via YouTube, we repost them on Instagram, and then that allows them to be able to gain a few hundred, maybe a thousand, few more views on their YouTube videos through that promotion, right? We offer logo services. We can get your logos, mixtapes, any type of cover, banner, anything like that done within 24 hours, right? So because we're a hip-hop entity, and I feel that I'm pretty knowledgeable with the amount of different things I've gone through in the scene, I can see the holes of what people may need, and I just try to fill those.
What would you say are some advice for people when they're trying to use social media to increase their brand awareness?
Content. Have content, right? Develop some kind of a regiment as far as posting, right? If you're not an everyday poster, like if you don't feel that your audience needs to see you every day and you're still able to grow them and keep them, then every 2 days that they expect to see you, show up and give them content. If you're just starting off, then give them content, right? Be on there every day, some kind of entertaining content besides your music videos. If you're an artist, a lot of the content you only have is your music video. Once you put that out and you put out the few clips here and there, you're not done. You know, you can't just go dormant until your next song drops. You have to constantly be giving them maybe behind the scenes. What you're doing in your regular time, you know, that engages you more with the audience because they get to see your personality, right? You really have to show up on social media these days, right? It's a grim reality for some of the people who might not be willing to put that amount of time in. But it's an inevitability. You gotta put the time in, and in order to do that, you have to have content. Meaning, you have to have a lot of content so you're not repeating, just putting up the same thing that you put up yesterday, right? I put out a 10-minute video on YouTube that allows me to have 10 minutes worth of content that I can push through Instagram. If I'm pushing a 1-minute clip, I have 10 clips for one day off of one 10-minute YouTube video.